So let's have a go at this A-level question. The context is that a plane is leaving from Cairns to Brisbane. It leaves at noon, traveling at a speed of 570 kilometers an hour. At Brisbane, it rests for 1 hour. Then it travels to Melbourne at a speed of 540 kilometers an hour and lands at 6:30 p.m. Okay. Then they tell us that the overall journey was a speed of 555.6 kilometers an hour. So the first thing that we can work out is the time from Cairns to Melbourne. How much time did it take?
I don't know, half, was it?
Yeah.
5.5 hours, right? Because it left at noon, landed at 6:30, so that's 6.5, take away the one, it's 5.5. Okay, so that means that we can work out distance now. The overall distance would be speed times time, which is 555.6 times 5.5, and it comes to?
3,055.8 kilometers.
Okay, excellent. Right, so that's the overall distance. Okay, and we have to calculate the time and distance from Cairns to Brisbane, and the time and distance from Brisbane to Melbourne. Alright, so really it's a two-part question where we have the speed of the first journey from C to B, and the speed will be equal to distance over time. And from Brisbane to Melbourne, we have a second speed, a second distance, and a second time. Okay. We know what the speed here is. It's given to us. It's 570. And the second speed is 540. And so we have two unknowns. Two variables, which means we need two equations to solve two variables. All right. So couldn't we say here that D1 is equal to 570 times T1? And over here, D2 is equal to 540 take away T2.
Do you mean times?
Ah, sorry. Yes, thank you. And couldn't we say that D2 is equal to, can we write D2 in terms of D1? If the overall distance was 3,000, part of that is D1. So D2 is really 3,000.
Oh, it makes sense now.
And 55.6 take away D1. And likewise with the second time, it would be 5.5 hours take away T1. So substituting that over here then, actually I'll finish this off, so D2 is 3,055.6, take away D1, is equal to 540 times T2, which is the same as 5.5, take away T1. Yeah? With me on that one. So I need to do a little bit of rearranging here to make D1 the subject.
Still got two variables.
And I get 3,055.6 take away 540 times 5.5 take away T1. So we'll call this one equation 1, and we'll call this one equation 2. Close it right there.